our disposal, which ensure the preservation of our open space, including our subdivision and land development ordinance and our zoning ordinance. We are already fighting hard to maintain our rural character. Let's continue to do so without putting it on the backs of current taxpayers. We do not need new tax for very little direction. Thank you.
Information, make a good decision, and that did not happen in this process. And the fact that you're referring to Facebook as a reference for accurate information, that's a joke. That is a joke.
I don't think we're listening correctly.
I don't care. What I'm annoyed about is just the nonsense that I have heard for the last week, for months. It's, you know, and maybe it's not coming from the board, but it's coming from all the people in this township. Everyone has their own spin on it. We've been talking about using eminent domain. We're going to use eminent domain now that we have this tax money. That's what's been going around. And you know, Solicitor, that they can't be used for that. The state prescribed how that question of the referendum has to appear. Am I right? It's not something somebody made up last minute to try to trick people. These are the kind of things that make me nuts. Your farm is preserved. The county purchased your development rights. That was done using taxpayer dollars, right?
That was the state.
Then it's fine. I'm good with it. But, you know, I've heard it. People saw it flapping when you said you preserved your farm, and you should be flat. But they also thought that somehow there weren't taxpayer dollars involved. There are taxpayer dollars involved.
Nobody said there wasn't.
No, that's the way the air kind of got left and people started to clap. I think it's a great thing to preserve the farm. Don't get me wrong, but people need to understand how the system works. It makes me nuts that we get all this misinformation from our residents and it doesn't make great. So all I'm asking is, have somebody come in and make a presentation on open space preservation. Just because we're engaged in a comprehensive planning process doesn't mean that one of the conclusions of that process is going to be to establish an open space fund. I mean, other townships around us do that. It doesn't matter whether the boards are R's or D's. In fact, in many cases, the boards are totally R. It's not a partisan thing. That's my only request that we follow through.
They're not designed facilitation, basically gets changed into a potential basin.
You're entirely right, sir, yes.
And as was pointed out by somebody else at that meeting, we have an ordinance in our saldo that says that no use occupancy permits are to be given until that final completion of the stormwater management system. And this is a question for Carrie, or for Delwar. Carol said that perhaps our ordinance might not be valid because there's a state ordinance that might supersede it or something. Is that true?
Yeah,
you're a lawyer. She's an engineer. She knows how to do
it. She's smarter than that. and we're wrestling with this in other municipalities as well. If the state acts in a certain area, it preempts the local municipalities from acting in that same area. So this is one of those intersections where you might have an ordinance on the books, but the state law may well preempt your ability to enforce that ordinance.
And may well or does, that's my question. Our ordinance has something in it that says, if our ordinance is more restrictive, our ordinance shall be one that are compliant with it.
I don't have them in front of me, but I'd have to take a look. But also, there's an element here of the Montgomery County Conservation District is usually the point person for enforcement of those problems when it comes to detention basins and retention basins.
But they don't enforce our salvo.
No, they wouldn't enforce the local, but if they have provisions in place, and usually they're approving the plans for these DNS controls, then seems to me they'd be the first one to be contacted when you experience a problem like you talked about.
But we're the ones that decide whether that is or is not going to be
true.
That has nothing to do with it.
Agreed, but that gets back to whether our ability to enforce that specific ordinance is preempted by state law in that area.
Yeah, 100%. I really would like a real answer to this question at some point. The reason being, one thing that I've never really considered about any of the stormwater stuff was what happens if the development project drags on for a long time. And I hadn't really thought about dragging on for a long time, but several other people at the meeting pointed out that it's a great possibility that it happens all the time. And in fact, there's been situations where we brought up early in the discussion of this project. What happens if the township issues permits and people move in, and then something happens with the development that doesn't get completed, and then those people have to sue the township to complete the project.
Usually you have public improvements, roads that are going to be dedicated to the township, and then you have quasi-public improvements, basins, stormwater basins, might not be dedicated to the township, but they certainly serve a public purpose. And so, presumably, those items, including the quasi-public improvements, are listed as line items on the estimate of probable cost, that is, the basis for the financial security that makes sure that those improvements aren't completed. So if the developer walks away or the developer drags it out for too long, you have that fund they can go to. And if necessary, a default can be declared. We're talking probably about a legal morass here, but you can declare a default and pursue that money in order to completely
why the escrow is important. security is in place, and that's why our engineers are stingy about peace and security, because I've been in those situations where the government did go under, and we need to make sure there's enough money there to do this work.
Yeah, just to echo those last couple of thoughts there with that, with the retainage that's being held, it was brought up at the planning commission meeting that after a year goes by, that I guess it would be the engineer would say, you know, we need to increase this by 10%. So I believe we're already past the year's time period. And Carol had just released a big release to them. So I think it's prudent that we add that 10% at this time, since we still don't have any idea. You know, they might be coming next week to do Schwenk Road, but we don't have any idea what they're doing on site for the balance of the roadway and the rest of the piping system.
That's it. Up to the chairman. Make a motion.
Awesome.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.